This is the last simplex table because in this table our ZJ minus F1 will become positive and we will calculate the value of X1 and X2 in this table. So in the 7th and 8th tutorial, our corresponding column is P1. So when we make the simplex table 3, we change identity vector P4 from P4 to P1. So right here, P1, and its value is 6 as the objective function, and P2 will be same because this is not our corresponding column in simplex table 2, so its value will be 7. Now I already explained which values you write here and here. I just write this. Actually, we calculate corresponding rows value is calculated selected number divide key numbers 3, 1, 0, 1, -1, 4, 3 divided 4, and above value is also calculated selected number minus corresponding row multiply with corresponding column divide by key numbers. So I calculate it 2, 0, 1, 1 divided 2 and -1 divided by 2. So when we multiply with 7 into 2, 14, and 6 multiply with 3, 18. 18 plus 14 is 32. And 7 multiply with 0, 0, 6 multiply with 1 and add it will be 6. 7 multiply with 1 and 6 multiply with 0 and add it will be 7. And 7 multiply with 1 divided 2 and 6 multiply with minus 1 divided 4 and add it, it will be 2 and it will be 1. And if we deduct F1 value from ZJ, we calculate 0, 0, 2, 1. So ZJ minus F1 is positive or 0. So here we calculate the value of X1 and X2. X1 value will be 3 and X2 value will be 2. Our answer X1 is equal to 3 and X2 is equal to 2. Because ZJ minus F1 is 0 or positive. This is our answer. If you have any question, please comment on this video. Thank you very much.